Good morning, boys and girls, and welcome back to our series all about forgiveness. Last week, we talked about why I should forgive. But this week, we're going to discuss the question, how do I forgive? But first, I have a question for you. Have you ever wanted to pay someone back for what they did to you? Have you ever sought to get revenge for something that's been done to you? If so, the good news is you are not alone. Even one of the most famous Bible heroes fell into the trap of trying to get revenge. Do you think you know who I'm talking about? Well, you'll find out shortly in our Bible lesson. But right now, I want you to check out this video.
And welcome back to this series called
Forgiveness.
Okay, seriously, where is that coming from? Anyway, I was just watching one of my favorite shows when I noticed something crazy. The evil Mr. Broccoli came and attacked Super Cupcake. All of Dessertland was so angry with evil Mr. Broccoli that they decided to take revenge. They made a big bowl of cheese and dumped it all over him. Have you ever wanted to do something like that? Maybe not dump cheese all over somebody. That would be kind of silly. But have you ever wanted to take revenge? There's a guy in the Bible named Samson who definitely thought about taking revenge. In fact, his revenge was big and way scarier than a bowl of cheese. We are not supposed to choose revenge. Instead, we need to choose
forgiveness.
People are going to do things to hurt us.
Take that. Ha.
But we need to do what's right. Don't be like Samson. Choose to forgive. In your lesson today, you're going to learn about the crazy revenge that Samson took on his enemy. You're going to learn how we must choose
forgiveness.
Oh my. Until next time, this is Ashton. See ya.
Hey guys, it's Austin again. Revenge never works. It is definitely not God's plan for our lives. God doesn't want us to repay evil with more evil. He wants us to pray for and ask for forgiveness to those who hurt us. And that's exactly what you're going to be learning about in your lesson today. But right now, let's check out this video with Wiggy Pop.
What you gotta know? What you gotta know? What you gotta know? What you gotta know?
Hey there, kids! My name is Wiggy, Wiggy Pop, and I'm here to have a rockin' time telling you what you gotta know. Today, we're answering the question, how do I forgive? So every time today that you hear someone ask you what you gotta know, you tell them this: I will forgive you no matter what you've done. Wait a sec, no matter what they've done? Well, what if they say something bad about me? What if they mess up my guitar? What if they hurt my feelings? Even then, God wants us to forgive others no matter what they have done. So every time today that you hear someone ask you what you gotta know, you tell them this: I will forgive you no matter what you've done. And that right there is what you gotta know. My name is Wiggy Pop, and I'll see you next time. Rock on!
All right, boys and girls, jump up to your feet because it's time for praise and worship. Go ahead and get ready to glorify the Lord, the King of Kings, because He is worthy of our praise.
Yeah.
what you gotta know. Hey kids, what time is it?
Yay!
You gotta know!
All right, boys and girls, it is time for the Bible lesson. In today's Bible lesson, we will be looking at a story in Judges 14 through 15. So go ahead and grab your Bibles and turn to Judges chapters 14 through 15. Now in today's Bible lesson, we will be talking about one of the strongest men in the Bible. Can you guess who it is? Well, I hope you said Samson, because that is who we are going to be talking about. Now, in Judges 14, Samson fell in love with a Philistine woman. The Philistines were the enemies of Samson's people, the Israelites, and the Philistines were very wicked. Now, even though he knew better, Samson decided to get engaged to the Philistine woman. He threw a big pre-wedding party and he got a little drunk. And he shouldn't have done that, and he ended up acting very prideful. He decided to challenge the Philistines who attended the party. So he stood up in front of them and he told them a riddle. He said he would give brand new clothes to anyone who could answer the riddle. Now the Philistine men went behind Samson's back and made his fiance tell them the answer to the riddle. When the Philistines guessed the answer, Samson got very angry. He knew that they had gotten his fiance to tell them the answer. So he ran out of the banquet hall. He found 30 other Philistine men. He beat them up, stole their clothes to give to the Philistines who had answered the riddle. Now, his future father-in-law had decided when he left that he was going to give Samson's fiance in marriage to Samson's best man or his friend. Now, when Samson came back to the banquet, he was told, "Your fiance has married your best man." Of course, this made Samson really, really angry. So he said, "This time I have a right to get even with the Philistines. I will really harm them." So he went out into the fields nearby. He ran around until he had caught 300 foxes. Now that is a lot of running around if you ask me. Samson set their tails on fire and let them loose in the wheat fields that belonged to the Philistines. The Philistines needed that wheat to make food to eat, but Samson destroyed the fields to get revenge. This kept going back and forth and back and forth. Samson took revenge on the Philistines, and then the Philistines would take revenge on Samson. So many people got hurt, but nothing was ever really resolved. That's what happens when revenge is your only desire. In our lesson today, we are going to learn how to forgive rather than take revenge.
What you gotta know? Thank you. Oh, please hold the applause. Thank you. Well, I am the actor, and I'm here to teach you today's power verse. And if you want to be a great method actor like myself, you must know the power verse. So let's get to it. Today's power verse says, "Never pay back evil with more evil." Romans 12:17. What a stupendous power verse! But if there's anything I've ever learned, it's that you'll never forget your lines, or the power verse in this instance, if you say it completely in character. So to help us, let's select today's character from the character box. Ah, yes! Today's character is a hip-hop dancing caterpillar. Interesting. Acting, thank you! Now, today's character is really a fish. So I want you to take your little fingers and go like this, as we say it. I want everyone to stand up on the count of three. One, three. Never pay back evil with more evil. Romans 12:17. Acting, thank you. Wow, that was superb. Well, I must get going, so I'll see you later, boys and girls. Exit stage left.
All right, guys, it's time for worship. Go ahead and stand to your feet, close your eyes, make sure that you're not being distracted by anything, and in these next few minutes as we sing this song, make this a time of prayer and worship to the Lord.
I can't stay here, asleep to how you're moving. I can't stay here, complacent anymore. I can't stay here. My heart is full of longing. I can't stay here. I know what I'm made for. You're breathing new life into dry bones. I hear the echo, the sound of heaven's song. Your spirit's calling me. I know it's time to go. I can't stay here anymore.
And I can't stay here. I'm awakened to your whisper.
You know, guys, I was thinking about that story of Samson that Elena shared with us earlier, and there was something kind of strange about it. Samson was one of the strongest men that we ever knew, right? That's what Elena talked about earlier, one of the strongest men in the Bible. He was so strong with his muscles and the physical. But you know what? He wasn't strong enough to resist the temptation to get revenge. And you know something else about our Bible story I noticed? The Philistines hurt Samson, and then Samson got revenge on them. Then Samson hurt the Philistines, and the Philistines got revenge on him. Then, well, I think you get the point. It was this unending cycle, and it just left everyone feeling overwhelmed, and that's what revenge does. And our Bible story that Elena shared with you actually has a lot to teach us about the dangers of revenge. There are three lessons that I think that you and I can learn today from studying this story of Samson. The first one is that people will do me wrong. People will do me wrong. They will do you wrong. It is a guarantee that this is gonna happen in your life. And you might be thinking right now, wow, Miss Tracy, that's kind of sad. Why would you say that? Because I know it's true. You know why? Because people are not perfect. There's no one on this earth who is perfect. Jesus was the only one who lived on earth and was perfect. So people will let you down. It might be someone that you're super close to. It might even be a friend or a family member. It could be a perfect stranger, a bully, it doesn't matter. But people are going to let you down in this life. It might be a bully at school who they hurt you. They really let you down. They hurt you. It could be someone who talks about you behind your back. Sometimes that happens and it hurts, but sometimes it's even someone you're super close to, like a family member or even your best friend. How many of you have ever had that happen? Even I have. When I was younger, I dealt with this too. It happens in life because sometimes your best friend will turn their back on you and you don't even know why and it doesn't even make sense. But I'm just here to tell you that people are not perfect and sometimes they're gonna let you down. So when that happens, what is our response? Often, we want to get back at them. We want to hurt them like they've hurt us. We want to take revenge. Maybe they hit you. I talked about that a couple weeks ago, so you want to hit them back, right? Or maybe they talked bad about you, so you want to talk bad about them. Or maybe they turn their back on you, and they're not even there anymore, and you don't even know why, and so now you want to turn your back on them. But you know what that's called? Revenge. And the Bible says something very specific about that. The Bible says, I can't pay them back. Our power verse even teaches us. It says, never pay back evil with more evil. So although I may want to hurt those who've hurt me, I can't do it. Why? Because revenge never solves anything. Think back to the story of Samson. Did it help him when he tried to get revenge? No, it just created that unending cycle we talked about. Where does it end? Revenge is not the way to go. So if I can't get back at someone who's hurt me, then what am I supposed to do? The answer is not an easy one. I'm sorry to tell you that. It's not easy, but it's exactly what the Bible says. And so I know that if I'm obeying God's word, God will help me. And the Bible says I must forgive and pray for those who hurt me. Now I know what you're thinking right now. What? You want me to pray for that person? You must be crazy. Remember, I said it's not easy. I've had to do it before. I've had to pray for people who hurt me. Even though I was crying and hurt and sad, I still had to pray for them. And you know what? That's exactly what Jesus tells us to do. In Matthew 5:44, it says, pray for those who persecute you. So instead of trying to get revenge on the person who's done wrong, we need to pray for them. Did you know that praying for someone is one of the best ways to show God's love to them? Wow, never thought about that, huh? Why don't you pray for their heart to be changed? Pray for their lives to be blessed. Pray that they'll give their lives to Jesus. Maybe they don't even know Jesus. Maybe that's why they act the way they do. You could be the one to show them the love of God. I'm praying for them. And you know what? I'll tell you a little secret. When you pray for someone who's done you wrong, it's impossible to hate them. That's exactly right. There's an old saying that says, if you talk about people to other people, you're gonna hate them. But if you talk about people to God, guess what you're gonna do? You are going to love them. So pray for your enemies. Maybe it's not an enemy. Maybe it's that close friend or that family member. Pray for them. Show them love every chance you get. You never know what God has planned for that person, and that's why it's so important that you shine a light, that you show God's love, that you don't take revenge, that you forgive them and you pray for them. And that's exactly what we're gonna do today. You know, the last few weeks of this lesson talking about forgiveness, we've been praying for ourselves and we've been asking God to forgive us. We've been asking for God's help to set people free from that prison that we've put them inside of our hearts so that we wouldn't be bitter. But today, we're gonna turn the tables a little. Today, I want you to think of that person that has done you wrong, that person that's hurt you, whether it's an enemy or whether it's that best friend that you no longer have. And today, as I pray, I want you to say their name to God. I want you to call their name out to God. I want you to pray for this person who has done you wrong and watch what God is gonna do. You can do it. Come on, let's pray right now. God, we just come before you today with such a thankful heart that you are so good to us and so loving to us and so caring, and you've given us your word to teach us and to show us what to do. Today, we want to apply this lesson that we've learned from Samson, and we want to not take revenge even though we think it would make us feel better. We trust your word and we know that that is not the right thing to do. So instead today, we say the name of these people who have hurt us before you. Right now, just say that name, boys and girls. Say the name before the Lord. God, we call out these names and we pray for these people. First of all, I pray for their hearts, that their hearts would be changed, that they would maybe realize the wrong that they've done, that they would seek forgiveness, that they would have a change of heart, that they would not want to act the way that they have acted anymore. God, maybe there's something that has happened to this friend, this person, this bully. There's something that's happened in their life that's causing them to act the way they're acting. Only you know. But Lord, we're asking right now, if that's the case, that you would bring healing to their life for whatever has caused them to act the way that they are. Lord, would you bring healing? Would you bring restoration? Would you show this individual right now where they are that you love them so much and that you would forgive them and that you would heal all the hurt and all the pain in their lives? And now, God, with your help and your strength, we pray blessings over this individual. That's right. Bless them, Lord. Bless them abundantly. And help me help the children to be a light to them and show them the love of Jesus. And we just say thank you, Lord, because we know that when we pray and we stand in agreement, you're already working. And so we say thank you in Jesus' name. Amen.
Rewind!
All right, boys and girls, it's time to review today's lesson with Rewind. So let's go ahead and start with question number one. What you gotta know today? I will forgive you no matter what you've done. I will forgive everyone, or God forgave me, so I forgive you. The correct answer is, I will forgive you no matter what you've done. Moving on to the next question. What was the name of the strong man in our Bible story today? Was it Samuel, Samson, or Sandy? Who do you think it was? Well, I hope you said Samson because that is the correct answer. Question number three. What did Samson try to trick the men with at the party? Did he try to trick them with a riddle, a puzzle, or a song? The correct answer is a riddle. Samson tried to trick the men with a riddle at the party. Moving on to question number four. Who told the men the answer to Samson's riddle? Was it Samson's fiance, Samson's mom, or Samson's daughter? Samson's fiance is the one that told the men the answer to Samson's riddle. Question number 5. What did Samson do to get the 30 sets of clothing? Did he wash them? Did he steal them? Or did he pay for them? He stole them. Moving on to question number 6. According to our lesson today, people will do me blank. Will they do you wrong? Or will they do you right, according to our lesson? Well, I hope you said wrong, because that is the correct answer. According to our lesson today, people will do me wrong. Question number 7. According to our lesson today, I can't blank. I can't pay them back. I can't get my revenge. Or I can't let them win. The correct answer is, according to our lesson today, I can't pay them back. Moving on to question number 8. According to our lesson today, I must forgive and blank for those who hurt me. I must forgive and love, I must forgive and bless, or I must forgive and pray. The correct answer is, I must forgive and pray for those who hurt me. Question number 9 is true or false. Revenge always solves the problem. Now, if you think the answer is true, jump up to your feet. If you think the answer is false, stay sitting down. Revenge always solves the problem. Well, I hope you stayed sitting down, because the correct answer is false. Now, moving on to the last question, question number 10. Where was our power verse found? Was it in Romans 12:17? Was it in Mark 2:7? Or was it in Colossians 7:12? Do you remember? Well, I hope you said Romans 12:17, because that is where our power verse was found today, and that is the end of Rewind.
Boys and girls, I am so proud of you today. It takes a lot of courage and a lot of strength to pray for those who have hurt you, and I am proud of you, and I challenge you now, throughout this week, continue to pray for that individual. Don't forget, don't walk away today and say, okay, I'm done. Keep praying for them and watch what God does when you choose to bless those who persecute you. I love you, and I hope to see you soon. Bye, boys and girls.
Hey guys, it's Austin again. Revenge never works. It is definitely not God's plan for our lives. God doesn't want us to repay evil with more evil. He wants us to pray for and ask for forgiveness to those who hurt us. And that's exactly what you're going to be learning about in your lesson today. But right now, let's check out this video with Wiggy Pop.